How's everybody?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, we were here on Monday night doing prayer. We always pray in the Spirit. And the Bible tells us we know not what we pray for. So I had no idea, you know, what was coming the next day. The next day, Tuesday, about 3:30, I get a phone call from one of J-Town's friend's mother. He's got two friends that are brothers. One is in J-Town's class, the other one, his name is Isaiah. He's in the third grade, I think. His mother called and asked me, was Isaiah with me? And I said, no, I haven't even been up to school yet. And she said, well, he's missing. He's left school, nobody knows where he is. And she said, he just called me for work, and she's on the way up there. I said, okay, I'm heading to the school right now. I jumped in my truck, and I started heading towards school, and I said a prayer. I said, God, wherever he is, protect him, keep him safe, and keep him well. And then I asked him, just show me where he is. It was 2 minutes. I turned the corner on Southwest Boulevard, and there he was. God is amazing. He showed me. He was this young man, he was scared, he was alone, and he was walking fast. And Southwest Boulevard, you know, it was a 4-lane highway. At that time of day, it's pretty busy. I was looking for a place to turn around and I couldn't find one. So I just did a U-turn in the middle of the street. I had to. I didn't want to lose sight of him. So I did, and I drove up on the curb when he was walking. And I let my window down. And I said, Isaiah, don't you know your mom, the school, the police, everybody's looking for you? And he was trying to explain to me why he had left school. I said, you can explain it when we get you to school. Just get in the truck. He didn't want to get in the truck. You know, this is a young man that knows me real well. He spent a night at our house. But he was so scared, you know. But he was just a little bit confused. So I told him, if you don't get your behind in this truck, there's going to be trouble. So he got in. You know, and I was asking him, I said, why don't you leave school? He said, one of his friends, grandmother, came up there and got a grandkids, and then asked him did he want to go to McDonald's with them. And he just said, yeah. You know, so he left for it. Well, by the time we got him to the school, you know, they had already looked at the surveillance cameras, and they saw him leaving with this lady and his kids. They were just about getting ready, you know, to put out the Amber Alert just before I called. I told him, I said, I got your son, we're headed to the school. But the thing is, like I said, Monday night when I was praying in the Spirit, like we always do, we have no idea what we're praying for or what's coming. You know, God always knows. And I just thank God that he hears us when we pray, and he answers our prayers. I was almost in tears, but I was so thankful that God handed us to me before the harm came to their reward. Amen. So he saved, you know, and it was weird, but it turned out the way God intended for it. Amen.
God, hallelujah. Intercessions, hallelujah. Those standing on, standing in the gate, hallelujah. Well, anymore, it has been another one before we receive today's offer.